Hello everyone, welcome back to a new video here on my YouTube channel. Today we're going to be having a look at Inborn Right spawning, as the Red Terran is going to be Innovation, and in the top left it's going to be TYTY, starting with a depot behind his mineral line. This is the first ever TVT I've casted on this channel, I believe. So that's a little bit exciting. A premiere, a first, a TVT virgin up until now. Let's have a look what's going to happen in this beautiful TVT. So we see a gas first opener coming out of TY, who then goes into a barracks. On the other hand, we see a barracks first from Innovation with the standard ramp wall. Now it's going to be important to see whether there's going to be a second gas for any of these two players, as there's really two ways to open in a TVT. It's either with this kind of delayed initial gas and then staying on one gas, going for that fast command center, or what TY is doing here. As we see on the minimap, second refinery is being taken to go into that heavier tech, faster factory, early two reapers, seeing what he's going to be able to do. Perhaps try to put on some pressure. Well, perhaps definitely going to be putting on some pressure on Innovation to figure out what type of pressure this is and to react properly to this. It's going to be exciting to see what Innovation will decide to do. These guys have played each other millions of times over the past years. Okay, that's a slight over-exaggeration, but they've played each other a lot, so they know each other's styles. TY usually is the guy who comes with the funky builds. Innovation, the macro god, who he does have different builds, and he doesn't play just one build, but he likes to be a little more reactive usually. Very standard player, good responses to having very solid mechanics. And people think that people with solid mechanics usually are late game gods, but I think Innovation really shines in the mid game, in at least most matchups. When I think of his TVP, his TVZ, his mid game is really where he does shine. Very solid control, good decision making, insanely good unit movement. TY, on the other hand, is usually the early game god, right? And more the late game. Like, he's good in the mid game, but he's known for very good late game control and very interesting early game openers. Now we do see that SCV and the Reaper trying to make a play here. Going for the Reaper, trying to do some damage on the Marine, not going to work. Where's that second Reaper? Is there a second Reaper? Yes, second Reaper is on the way out. Ramp over here will offer some safety for TY's Reaper and his SCV. So gets out of there without any real damages. Now what is he opting for? Pulled out a gas for the faster command center. Now of course Innovation is not aware of that. Builds a bunker, will be moving up into the high ground. In this case, I wonder, do you just stay on the high ground and
add on complete?
Just hope that he doesn't run by the bunker, because there is two SCVs here that will now be in danger. One good grenade, two Reapers and a heavy, and then two SCVs are down. Bunker is getting attacked right now. Marines are being rallied towards the one Marine and the Reaper. Hellion is out, so should be able to contest this, especially together with the bunker. We'll be able to get those Marines to safety. Might be able to even grab a Reaper here. Does grab at least one Reaper. Might get a second Reaper, or even better, the Hellion. Does get the Hellion. Will he lose anything? Wow, Jesus. What a control here by Innovation. I don't like that he's moving out with his Hellion. Only has 6 HP left. A shot of literally everything, bar perhaps a Marine and an SCV will one-shot it. Wouldn't mind to just see it getting repaired. Now, that was absolutely insane. That was very, very good control by Innovation there, who knows his timings a lot better than I know the timings, and will be able to pick up two SCVs here. We'll lose the Hellion for it, but that's definitely worth it, especially because he already had the faster expand, fast third gas going down, of course, to try and build on that Raven count. First Raven starting faster for Innovation, but only because TY has a medevac on the map. Does get spotted. Innovation knows what's happening. He sees the switch, knows there was a tech lab on that factory before, so it can either be a Cyclone or a tank in here. Reaper dealing a lot of damage. Did he get more workers, or was that still the old workers? 3 kills total, so I believe he got at least one more worker. How many workers have gone down so far? No, only 2 workers, so I didn't get another worker. I'm sorry for that. Do we have a Cyclone? I believe there was a Cyclone, yes. Out of position though. Pure Marine. Oh, straight walking into tank fire. 4 Marines against 4 Marines, plus a medevac. Will not end well for the 4 Marines that are already a little bit low. Cyclone pops in as well, here to join the party. This should be it should be pushed away with relative ease here. Oh, shot once again by TY. Innovation's just barely walking into range, and we'll have to pay a price for that. Now first Raven is out here for Innovation. Slight supply lead and slight worker lead, but not the biggest of deals. Is up in, or should be up in Raven count. It's 1 against 1 now. Actually, second Raven is about even as well. We'll see players go into two or three Ravens, depending a bit on how many they want to get, obviously. Three depots being thrown down here for TY, who's walking into a small supply block. Now, we haven't seen a third CC come down here, but it's just a matter of time. We see 400 minerals in the bank for TY as well. So we're just waiting to see where that's going to be placed. Could be down on the location. Yes, indeed it is. TY still feels like he's in control of the game, together with this medevac, of course. Is there anything to deal with this Raven harass that's going to come out of innovation? I'm not quite sure if there is. I'm going to be honest with you here. First turret does go down. We'll be able to get one SCV. Good pull away immediately by TY, even though he didn't have vision off the edge. It is cat-like reflexes. We'll be able to deal with it. Ooh. They're being thrown down next to the tank. That's cute. Of course, tank, when sieged, won't be able to shoot right next to him. A lot more SCVs going down here, as there's not a single Viking on the map. Two Vikings right now being built for innovation. And here comes the second Raven coming in for some plays. Once again, turret. It's a couple of kills. Two, three kills once again. 8 Marine drop is moving out. Is there Stim yet? No, there's not. Stim hasn't even started, so these are just regular Marines. There is 2 Vikings out already. There's 2 more Vikings on the way. We're seeing extra barracks being built, so we are seeing a bio versus bio game. Even though there's no extra barracks here, we know that, of course, the tech lab and the e-base here for TY are all indicative of indeed a bio play. Oh my god, innovation. Godly game sense. TY does spot it, innovation doesn't.
Command center upgrade complete.
I mean, he won't be able to snipe these. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. We have a push forward here coming out of TY with 3 Ravens against only 2 Ravens. He does not have air control, but might be able to snipe 1 or 2 SCVs here. Does get 2. Which is a bad view, but it's nice. Oh, if he loses a Raven, that could be bigger. Good disable there coming on the Cyclone. There's a lot of tanks here for innovation. There's enough Ravens. Vikings absolutely ruling the sky here for innovation as well. Lots of auto turrets doing some work there. I'm not quite sure who's winning this fight. I don't think Inno knows who's winning this fight either, because it isn't him. 3 Vikings still alive, pushes back. Only lost Marine so far, will end up losing 1 tank. Ah, these Vikings, they gotta be careful. 2 tanks have gone down at this point. Slightly up in resources lost. TY, but down in workers still, down in upgrades as well. No Stim done for him yet. No extra barracks yet. He really forgot about those. That can be on purpose, as we already have barracks 4 and 5 on the way for innovation. Reactor should be starting to go down here. Just gonna see Marine tank versus Marine tank. Air lead still in favor of innovation with... Oh my god, all the Ravens died for TY during that fight. I didn't even notice. It's a big investment in those Ravens that is now useless. We see a big Viking lead, 3 Vikings up here for innovation. Still has a Raven as well, which will definitely help with a disable and auto turret here and there. No sensor tower out of innovation yet, so not quite sure exactly where his opponent is positioned. TY moves forward. There is no Raven for disable on TY's side. Tanks will be able to do some damage. Vikings landing right now. We'll be able to get some splash on these tanks, but... One tank with 1 HP, one tank with 8 HP, and one tank with 16 HP. That's going to be very, very sour for innovation. Loses his Raven as well without using the turrets. Bit of a sloppy player, and TY is doing quite some damage in this case. Depot does end up falling. There's no more air control for innovation. He's down in tanks. The only thing he has going for himself is that he does have faster 1-1 upgrades, and he has way better production. He's already on 5 barracks. TY just now getting the reactors on 5 barracks at the same time. The question, of course, is how is he ever going to break out of this? I don't quite see it happen. This might be a relatively short game. Innovation sending out, oh, perhaps to intercept either Vikings or Marine reinforcements. Season into tank range. We'll be able to get 1 tank. We'll not lose anything else. Good siege there out of Innovation. Really knowing the limits of tank range, like you would. I would swear that this is in range. Look at that. Just barely on the edge. His foot is inside the circle. Well, tank foot. But I guess not big enough to shoot at. Oh, the SCV's right in front of him. Poof. Look. Oh, that one can survive. Even though I don't think he has vision of that. Maybe. No. Yeah, okay, yeah. He can shoot it. And splashes on the tank. Actually kind of dangerous. Look. Poop. Just like that. If he does that trick one more time, tank might end up dying. What's the Viking count for now? A lot of workers have gone down of innovation, 10 in total, 4 on the other side. We have another big counter drop coming out of Inno, who with us have 2-2 on the way. Combat shield isn't quite done yet for TY. These tanks will be able to take out these two, so innovation, even without air, will be able to slowly push out of this contain. There is 3 Vikings on the top side of the map here. We'll be able to spot this. What's there in the main base? There is nothing there. Once the tanks will be able to set up, that could be a pretty big deal. The old medevac does manage to unload. Tank does end up setting up. We'd love to see a scan here for innovation to see what he's up against. Oh, good cleanup meanwhile at home by innovation. Does cost him a little bit. It's going to be a costly drop as well for him. Let's get something done. Let's stop a couple of workers. TY is aware there's still a drop here. We'll be able to get it. Scan on the third base of innovation. 67 workers against 63, but innovation is way better. Upgrades on the way. Fourth base already done. So innovation, even though he was under so much pressure, managed to keep Macron, managed to keep his head cool. And TY really didn't. Ugh, this is a nasty mistake. Or is it a mistake? Does he decide it's time to just give up his main base, float to the fourth? Oh, I thought he just accidentally lifted it and then was floating it forward, but no, it's on purpose. So that's actually kind of odd. So you see innovation with a way higher work count is gonna have more income as well. You see him outmining his opponent by 600-700 minerals per minute. Innovation still down in Vikings, even in tanks, but up in upgrades. So if they can just get a marine versus marine fight with some tank support, that might be okay. Of course, these slow sieges will be in favor of TY, who does have air control with the Vikings. Another drop heading out here for innovation, trying to keep pressure onto his opponent. He'll be able to drop here, run into that third base. Not a single tank over there. TY rallying everything across the map. One tank in this location. Not quite sure what it's doing there. One Viking almost falls. 1 HP. 6 HP. Sensor tower will be able to get shot down here. Would love to see a second sensor tower, but good drop at the same time here coming out of innovation. Gets this sensor tower, will be able to grab this tank as well. Lots of SUVs will end up falling here. Another stim comes in. 2-2 against 1-1 marines. No medevacs for support either. Oh, this guy cost TY a lot of SUVs. And he's moving forward. 29 SUVs end up falling, and this puts TY in a pretty all-in position, but TY has plans for himself as well. Drops into the main base. I'd love to see one or two tanks here. There's not a single tank here. Two tanks would really boost this army so much. I mean, now it can just get cleaned up by running in tank, sieging forward. Pick up here out of TY. Still has a massive army, don't forget. He might be down in supply, but that's all in workers. His army is still 20 supply bigger. Now we'll be able to drop on top of these tanks. Most likely try to break this position. That did not go as planned. That did not go as planned at all. There's still two medevacs here in the dead space, but for innovation, all he needs to do is survive till 3-3. If he survives till 3-3, he's going to be in a fantastic spot. He has better eco. He has good production. Good enough. He's rebuilding his fourth base in his main. TY knows he needs to finish the game on 2-2 right now. There's no extra gases. He won't have the gas for 3-3. He doesn't have the gas for extra tanks or extra Vikings. Oh, innovation, what are you doing? Oh, dropping into your own main base for a defense. I like that. It's a safety play. Now we see Liberators pushing forward. We'll be able to pick up two tanks for now. Marines darting forward, immediately sniping two more tanks. So four tanks falling in a matter of seconds here. TY still up, 20 in army supply. Has the air lead, has the Liberators as well. So really to capitalize on that air lead. Even though innovation is in a leading commanding position when it comes to economy and upgrades. Pretty poorly done by TY. Too far forward with those Liberators. Oh, now sieging too far forward. Really playing quite sloppy here. Innovation decides to not kill that tank and just go back. Move these two medevacs away from the main base. There's no tanks here. Good drop here by TY, who will most likely be sieging forward at the same time. Doing a good job here. Drops once again. Could drop behind the mineral line or could drop on top of these tanks. We'll go for the drop on top of the tanks. How many tanks are there? 3 tanks remaining. 3-3 upgrades have finished for innovation. Plus 2 vehicle weapons have finished as well. Innovation will have to give up this base for now. With 3-3 upgrades, he might be able to fight into these marines. There's a lot of medevacs for Inno as well. How many marines do we have? 51 against 46. And perhaps a counter drop is really what is needed here. With those superior upgrades, trying to get reinforcements or trying to get the production so that this position can be reinforced. Innovation dropping down in tank count very rapidly. 4 against 11 currently. We'll be going for a full on bait. Oh no! What a blunder by TY. Losing his air control means he can't use the liberators to push forward anymore. Good drop at the same time though. Innovation struggling to hold his main base with all of these marines. They do have 3-3 but no medevacs there. Oh, Innovation going for a counter push. But I don't think this is going to work. There's plenty of tanks at home here for TY. Still has a lot here. All unprotected at this point. Couple of tanks sieging back up at home for Innovation. Oh, what a tense game this has been so far. Big drop. No sensor tower. Does TY smell it? Does TY smell it? No, TY's nose is not working. Oh, big drop. Oh, we'll lose a medevac with a lot of marines. Oh, two medevacs are going down. Tanks still shooting from the low ground. Up on the balcony over here. Lots of marines dropping, but no more tanks in this army. And even though he has 3-3, he will need to evacuate this position. TY, what are you going to be doing here? Just go home. TY decides, all right. I've done my job here. I killed a lot. He's losing a lot of workers now, so still should be careful. He's up in supply. But still that upgrade lead here for Innovation. So without tanks, it's very scary to walk in here. There's a lot of medevacs. It isn't that many marines though. And we see Innovation pushing out right now. How many tanks do we have? 6 against 11. 1 liberator against 0. There are 3-3 upgrades done yet. No, they're not. A bit of a sloppy pickup here by Innovation. The rocks Innovation is. And Innovation's patience is running out. Of course, just have those +2 vehicle weapons. It will help a lot. Oh, Inno, you can just walk in here, can you? Can he? Kills 2 tanks. Relatively good job. Hardly loses any marines. Perhaps he can. Unseizes absolutely everything. We see medevacs moving forward. What's the tank cover now? 11 against 7. There's 5-6 tanks siege up over here. Oh, Innovation, you can't do this. You can't do this. This is an absolute no. You can't just run in here, can you? Can you? Innovation's trying his best. Tanks are falling. Man, tanks do a lot less to marines than they do in my head. And we see Innovation slowly but surely evening up the tank count. Marine count is falling, but with these superior vehicle weapons, is doing a lot of damage here. Oh, a lot of tanks once again falling, but Innovation supply is plummeting. 95 armor supply against the 68 of Innovation. Oh, makes a stand though. Does end up making a stand. There's a drop on the other side of the map. 8 marines doing a lot of damage to the main base. SCV after SCV is falling. As Innovation inches forward with these tanks. Slowly but surely. 74 armor supply against 86. Innovation still has an upgrade lead, but very far down in tanks. 8 tanks against 4 liberators are being constructed. What are these guys doing? Yeah, time to move down, no? What the hell? 144 supply against 109. 4 CC goes back to the lab. Well, it's the 3rd CC still. And we have another drop into the natural. Will TY be ready yet? TY will be ready. Not immediately, but once he sieges up, I think this will be the final stand of Innovation, as he can't rescue these tanks. Marines moving forward, liberator sieging up, and TY wins this extremely intense and just tense overall TVT on Nightshade. If you did like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, smash the like button, it helps me a lot, and I'll see you all next time for a new video. Bye bye.